me in time for that. Ooh, bus home.
Ellie, come here. Come here. Ellie, say hi.
Eventually found... Hi. Oh my god.
Cutest dog ever.
Hi everyone, this is Jen. Welcome back to my channel. I finally did my hair. I went platinum blonde. Hairstylist did a blueberry overtone sort of thing. I didn't get time to style my hair, so apologies. This is a Korean American makeup dupes video, which I've been planning for a long time, guys. I'm really excited because as soon as I was like planning this, I had so many ideas in my head. Obviously, Korean makeup and skincare is more budget. It is a little bit more creative and fun. Obviously, you do pay for what you get, but I think sometimes the products do have a bit of a bubble just because it's a brand name. The price is a lot higher just because of the affiliated imaging around it and everything. So yes, of course, there will never be like a completely exactly the same product. That's not what we're doing here. We're trying to find things that are similar and you can get similar results for it. But I'm going to be doing this series for anyone, whether you're like a complete pro or a noob in the K-beauty world. Noobs, you are all welcome. The K-beauty world is amazing and once you get sucked in, you will never leave. So one final thing before I start with this video is for my Musa fam anyway. I know I was supposed to do my updated Korean skincare routine video next, but the thing is I have been drinking these Gyeonggangtang. You know how last time I went to visit the hospital? It's basically this like magic herbal medicine thing that makes your skin beautiful and your insides and organs healthy and everything. And I knew that there's a purging process where my skin is like excreting all the toxins and stuff that was stored underneath. So I was actually holding off on drinking these because I was like, I need to film the skincare routine first. But alas, I could not wait. I really wanted to see how it changes my skin and my health and everything. So I started to drink them and yes, I started to purge. So the purging process will not last too long. So hopefully I'll be able to do it in my next video. So that's the explanation. The first dupe is for something that a lot of you guys would already know. So yes, starting with the most obvious one, Benefits Hoola. These two are one of the most popular contour products out there. Regardless of how many new Western products come out, I think everyone's staple is always gonna be Benefits Hoola. It's just infallible. So a cheaper Korean dupe that does equally as well and is probably the most famous contour kit in Korea is the Too Cool for School Art Class by Rodin kit. This one actually comes with three different shades and it does come with a full-size mirror as well, which the Benefit ones do too. And if you have a look at these colors, so this darker shade is actually really similar to this dark shade out here. I would say it's actually in between these two middle shades, and the light version is actually virtually the same as this light version as well, if not slightly lighter. So I actually find that the Too Cool for School one is a lot more usable for me personally. There is a lot less product in this, I think, because I tend to hit pan a lot more. I never hit pan on Hoola, never. I think once in my life. But this one I've like gone through two or three of them. But it's really versatile because it actually comes with both of them in one, if not like another extra shade. The pigmentation is great. It's similar kind of texture in terms of powderiness. It's really good quality and it's not crazy expensive. So that is a really great dupe for Benefits Hoola if you're first getting into K makeup. The color is not too reddish, so a lot of people love it, and it's not too grayish either. Another staple Benefit product is the Porefessional Primer. So this is basically a pore mattifying primer. It's meant to smooth the canvas out and help to reduce oiliness throughout the day. A Korean dupe for this one, which I have been talking about for years on my channel, is the Innisfree No Sebum Blur Primer. Okay, so have a look. So that's the Benefit one and that's the Innisfree No Sebum Blur Primer. They're similar size tubes. Innisfree is one of Korea's top selling brands globally. I'm not sure if the popularity is as big within Korea as it is outside. I think it's a little bit bigger globally. And it also claims to do the same thing of blurring the pores and helping to keep your oil at bay throughout the day. I mean, look at it. It's so similar. They're same squeezy tubes. They function the same. The Innisfree one comes out a lot more matte and it just glides on and really like coats the surface and leaves it really smooth. And the pricing difference is like, whoop. So have a look into it if you're broke. You really want to try this Benefit one, but you know, you gotta save some money. Give your wallet some salvation. So next is a dupe for MAC Strobe Cream in Red Light. So this is definitely a staple in a lot of makeup enthusiasts' kits. If you're a makeup artist, you probably have every color. But for today's one, it's the Red Light one, which is the sort of salmon pink undertone one. It goes on as a white pearl, but as you blend it, it leaves a cast of pinkish red. It's really beautiful. It's great for under makeup. You can also mix it with your foundation to add a bit of illumination. So the Korean dupe is the Herborian Glow Cream. It also applies like a cream in its squeezy tube form. I actually really like this brand. It's a new brand. It goes on white, and then as you blend it, same thing, this reddish pinkish pearl effect, which is really beautiful. If you want to look healthy, if you think about it, like when you go for a run and you have a bit of a pink flush on your cheeks afterwards, that looks healthy. So that's what you kind of achieve through using this type of strobe cream or illuminating base, but they're both virtually the same thing. This one actually is meant to offer a luminous blur effect and help you get that fresh, dewy look. Personally prefer the Herborian one over the MAC one. Something about the MAC one, it just kind of disappears, but this one continues to give you this refreshed, moisturized feel, which is great for those who have dry skin. But yeah, these are for all different skin types, so do have a look into these. For another primer-based product, the Makeup Forever's Radiant Primer in Mauve. I actually use this a lot. It's like really great for those who have yellow undertones because it neutralizes the yellowness of the undertone and helps to make your foundations more neutral. I really do like it, but it comes with 30 mils of product and it runs out really, really quickly. Like a little does not go a long way with this product. So the Korean dupe for this is actually from a brand called IPKN, Ipkin. Saw this brand when I was really young. Then I didn't see it for a really long time, and now they've relaunched. This is the color correcting primer in purple. This actually contains SPF 15 on top of it as well, which the Makeup Forever one does not. Meant to correct redness, creates even surface, and helps discoloration. This also comes with 40 mils, so 10 mils more than this little baby here. But what I do notice is the Makeup Forever one is a little bit more of the color purple, whereas this one, because it's Korean and Koreans like to get a little bit of a brightened look, it does have a slight brightening effect, but both of these essentially do the same thing. This color is just a slight more whitening version, so I'd say it's the Asian version of this because Asian makeup is a little bit more, let's look brighter and healthier and glowier. As a big generalization, I know a lot of Westerns like that look too. You guys know what I mean. For foundations, one of the key foundations ever since I started my YouTube was actually the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation. Actually, I'm not a huge fan of this foundation, but I know a lot of people are, a lot of my friends are. This contains SPF 10 PA Double Plus. It contains 30 mils of product. It's a pump bottle and it's called Double Wear because it's just really long lasting and very high coverage. For me, I feel like it's a little dry and thick and can look cakey. I think a lot of people with normal to combination skin would like this a lot more. But why am I reviewing? The dupe for this is actually the new Etude House Double Lasting Foundation. This one contains SPF 34 PA Double Plus. You guys can do the math, 24 more SPF. This is also 30 grams, which is basically 30 mils, so same amount of product. It also has a pump bottle and also like a glass bottle. It's a lot lighter though. This is a lot heavier. I actually mentioned it in my recent new Korean beauty products video, which I'll link for you guys up there. Find that these are really, 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 really similar, except this is a lot thicker. It feels a bit heavier. This one really kind of disappears. So it is double lasting. It's meant to be long wear as well. Stay on the skin and help to reduce and keep your oil at bay throughout the day. So definitely a great dupe because this is so much more affordable than Estee Lauder's one. And if you can find a foundation that does essentially the same thing, then I think definitely go for it. Give it a go, guys. Double lasting foundation from Etude House. So next are for MAC eyeshadow palettes. They're always very pigmented and very smooth, but obviously the pricing is just a little steep. You do have to save up for it if you're on a budget. It doesn't mean necessarily that the colors are exactly the same. But they are rather similar and they look really similar as well, a little suspiciously similar. So this is actually the Solar Glow times 9 eyeshadow. And then this one here is the Brown Luxe. It's a little bit more on the khaki side. So Etude House, which is the most affordable makeup brand in Korea, one of the most, also has a very similar looking palette, almost to the point it's like, did they benchmark? I think they probably might have. The palette sizes are exactly the same. And they also have the round eyeshadows. This was the Pink Skull, which was also a limited edition, but they regularly come out with these kind of looking palettes. They're a fraction of the price. The colors are the Korean versions, which is a little bit more sheer, more subtle, and the undertones are just really made to suit, just as a generalization, Asian skin. So the colors are a little bit different from MAC. It is a very personal thing, but for me, throughout the years, like I remember when I started using makeup, I would follow all these YouTubers and they would rave on about different single eyeshadows from MAC, and I would go buy it, but it wouldn't look nice on me at all. Like, the color would be too cool toned or like way too red. Of course, back then I had no idea about personal color and undertones. It's not completely just about warm and cool undertones, by the way. But yeah, that was one of the downsides when it came to not just MAC, but also just all Western eyeshadows. There are a lot of eyeshadow palettes where I just personally don't end up reaching for the colors just because it doesn't bring out my everything. My features just don't come alive. It looks weird. But the thing with Korean makeup, not just for Asians, everyone can use it, but it really is targeted to be able to suit us. So each color is really flattering. Like, none of them can go wrong. So much cuter. Like, they come with the hearts in the middle, as you can see. They're actually beautiful. The bronze colors, the foiling on it, it's just really pretty. If you're into rounds and khakis, I have the perfect dupe for you for this one. And this is actually also from Etude House. It does not look the same, but it does have a really similar color theme, and it's so much more affordable. The Play Color Eyes in the Cafe, which I think they're still selling at the moment, comes with two sponge applicators. But look at the colors, guys. It's so similar. The foiled gold, khaki brown, it's got these colors up there. Let me show you guys the pigmentation of these. You'll be impressed. I mean, for Korean makeup, the cheaper it is or the more roadshop it goes, it doesn't necessarily mean that you get crappy stuff, which is I think one of the main attractions of K-beauty. A couple swatches from the palette. It also comes with a lot more different colors that you can play up with. This one has 5 shades. The Etude House comes with 10 shades, and it also includes some pretty corals and neutral nudes and stuff that you can blend with. By the way, if you're wondering what's on my lips today, because you guys always ask, I've got on these two today, the Apu Mulgwang Tinted in CR01, and then I've done a little gradient with the new Etude House Match Chic Lip Lacquer in Irene Red. I love this color. I've actually got the whole kit of this sent to me. If you guys would be interested in an unboxing swatch demonstration video, or if there are already too many out there you don't care, please let me know. But these are amazing. I love them. So now for those who are really into concealers. Two key Western concealers, for me anyway, are the Bobbi Brown Instant Full Cover Concealer and the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. Beautiful. They're so creamy. They're very pigmented. They don't cake. The packaging is great. Everything about it is just really good, except that it's pricey. So the Korean dupe versions, the ones that I chose that these are most similar to, are these two, called the SEM. You guys all know this, it's the Cover Perfection Tip Concealer. This is so popular that, like, if you go in stores in Korea, I think even till now, they have run out of the number ones. It's so creamy, it's so pigmented, it's so long lasting, and it's like so cheap, like $5, I think. It's just unbelievably good. So there's a reason why there's huge hype around this. And this one is the Chikai Chikko Matte Concealer. It's a matte fix matte concealer. The Korean one actually has 7 grams of product, and the Bobbi Brown one is 6 mils. This does a fantastic job. Without the concealer disappearing throughout the day, it really stays on. It's very, very high coverage. I have raved on about this for a long time, so I once again want to bring this to memory. But that one is matte. So if you're looking for another super cheap Korean one, the SEM's Cover Perfection Tip Concealer. It's really creamy. It's a little bit hydrating, so it'd be great for dry skin people. Another upside is that the Western ones don't contain any sunscreen, whereas the SEM one has SPF 28 PA++. You do usually have to touch up throughout the day, but these are a little bit heavy and big, honestly, to carry around. These ones are a lot smaller, definitely more travel friendly if you like to travel around with your concealers. So something to keep in mind. Last but not least, something that I personally love, and it is the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter Eyeliner. This is a gel eyeliner, and it has like a beautiful holographic multifaceted shimmer. I love applying a little bit underneath my eyes to bring it that pop, especially if I'm headed out at night times. Another beautiful dupe for this, and it's super affordable. Got it on today. I'm not sure if you guys can tell in this lighting. It is the Etude House Miraholic Liquid Eyes WH901 Crystal Shoes. The color is exactly the same. It does have a pink undertone to it with aqua glints and also bluish purple holographic. This one to me sometimes was a little bit too green. I love that this contains a little bit more white in it, so it gives you that cuter look and more wide-eyed and brightened effect. I like this applicator more, and that is a dupe that I'm really excited to tell you guys about. Yes, I finally shared it with you guys. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that this was truly helpful for you guys. I will have all the links for these down in the description bar below. As I said, this is a series, so subscribe if you want to stay tuned for future videos about K-beauty, Western makeup. But yes, of course, my Korean skincare routine updated version is coming soon as this purging clears out. I promise to have it up for you guys. Please thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it. I hope you guys have a really great week. I'm gonna head out with Oppa to have dinner now. Please also let me know what you guys think about my hair. Probably gonna be a different color in next video. So yes, don't get too used to it, as you guys know, with my hair. That's it guys, stay beautiful inside and out. Remember, you are beautiful, loved, cherished, valuable, and so talented. Why did you do that while I'm talking? Do you wanna say bye? Ellie says bye too. 다음에 또 봐요. See you guys in my next video. Bye.